हेलो बच्चों, हाउ आर यू?
आई होप यू ऑल आर गुड। ओके, नाउ इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर इन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल वी सॉ लैटिस एंथैल्पी एंड वी सॉ द डेफिनेशन ऑफ लैटिस। सो सपोज इफ यू टुक एग्जांपल ऑफ NaCl, ओके, सो इफ यू टुक हियर एग्जांपल ऑफ NaCl, सो सी हियर हाउ योर NaCl, सो दे आर डिसोसिएटिंग लाइक दिस, Na प्लस प्लस व्हाट Cl माइनस। So suppose that lattice enthalpy, if that lattice, if you dissolve in that water, so how it will act? So like this, so say here Na plus, okay, it is your cation part. So whatever your water, they are, means diagrammatically if you are considering, so like this, charges. Okay, so see, minus and plus, okay, so this minus and plus, okay, here minus and plus. Because this made a positive charge, okay, so oppositely charged, they will attract it like this, minus and plus, okay, minus and plus. Now here also what? Minus and plus, because these what made a positively charged, okay. So these are what regarding your Na plus. Now if you are considering your Cl minus, so your diagram is like this. If you are going to show diagrammatically, so here what? Yes, plus minus, okay, plus minus, plus minus hydration, okay, plus minus, understood? Here what beta? Plus and minus, like that cluster of ions here form, okay, if you this we dissolve in water, whatever here rock salt, NaCl is also called as what beta? Rock salt. Okay, so now we will move towards our next point, that is covalent bond. What beta? Covalent bond. So see here, covalent bond, what it is? Covalent bond. Co means what? Yes, it is what beta? Mutual sharing of electrons. Covalent bond means what? Mutual sharing of electrons. So as I already told, with a bond between, okay, bond between non-metal and non-metal is always covalent, okay. So mutual sharing of electron between the constituent atoms is called as what? Covalent bond. So if you we will see here some examples, okay, regarding your covalent bond. So see here covalent bond examples. Say formation of, okay, first example, formation of chlorine molecule. Formation of what beta? Chlorine molecule. So how this chlorine molecule will form? So before that you must know what is the chlorine formula. So chlorine molecule is what you had here, Cl2, okay, so that are present in our gaseous. Okay, what is the physical state of this Cl2 with gaseous? So see here, whenever we are forming this covalent bond between the chlorine molecule, so see here like this, chlorine to chlorine atom, okay. So as you know beta, chlorine, your atomic number, you must know here atomic number of your chlorine, okay. So atomic number of chlorine is what? 17. So their electronic configuration of what? Yes, 2, 8, 7, and here also what? 2, 8, 7. So always keep in mind, okay, so whatever these valence electrons, they are take part in bonding formation, okay. So see like this, means whenever we have to draw the structure, this whatever valence electrons we have to write, so see here like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, okay. So like this, here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, understood? So here we whatever your each one of the chlorine atom, they are trying to complete its octet, so they want electrons. So see here how it will trying to complete its octet, so like this, okay, understood? So see, we will count again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, here octet is completed. Okay, here what beta? Octet is completed for this chlorine atom. Now if you are considering for second, So see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Understood? So here, by accepting or between a mutual sharing, by mutual sharing, bond is formed. That bond is, we call it as what? Covalent bond. Mutual sharing between the two constituent atoms. Understood? So how here form this? So like this Cl. So we are writing like this. Understood? So one thing here you keep in mind. Okay. So whatever this two electron. Okay. So that we call it as a shared pair of electron. What we call this? Yes. What we call here? Shared pair of electrons. Okay, and whatever these valence electrons, okay, see, these are what beta, shared pair of electrons, and whatever these valence electrons, we call it as a what? Lone pairs. What beta? Lone pairs. So keep in mind this concept. So very much important is, okay, whatever that lone pairs, this does not take part in bonding formation. So we call it as a what? Lone pair. And whatever take part in bonding formation, we call it as a what? Bond pair. Or what? Shared pair of electrons. Simply we call this thing what? Bond pair. Is beta here? Bond pair. Okay. I hope you understood this formation of Cl2 molecule. Okay. So we will move towards our next example. Hydrogen chloride, hydrochloric acid, HCl molecule. Yes, beta. Formation of what? Second. See here. Formation of hydrogen. Yes, formation of hydrogen chloride. So, ready with this. So, beta, you must know first skeletal structure of that HCl. So, like this HCl here. Okay. So, whenever we are forming this HCl compound, H, okay, so how much valence electrons? First atomic number of hydrogen is 1. Okay, so here what will come? 1 only, because valence electron 1 only and atomic number also 1. And for the Cl, as you know, 287 electronic configuration and atomic number 17 for your chlorine. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so where? So always keep in mind hydrogen, they are completing what? Duplet. Duplet means what beta? 2 electron. Okay, it does not have capacity to complete this much, 8 electrons. So how much they are trying to complete is duplet. And whatever other, okay, your carbon, chlorine, okay, nitrogen, oxygen, they are completing what? Yes, 8 electron. How much? 8 electrons. So see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, so these are what? These your valence electrons, we call it as a what? Lone pairs. Okay, and this word beta, yes, bond pair. And bond pair, we also call it what? Shared pair of electrons. Yes, beta? Shared pair of electrons. Okay. I hope you understood this formation of HCl molecule. Okay. So these are simpler. Okay. If you concentrating on this, it is very much easy to form a covalent compounds. Okay. So now we will discuss here types of covalent bonds. Okay. You are ready with this? Yes. Say types of covalent, okay, types of covalent bonds. So see here, there are variety of covalent bonds. Okay, first we will discuss in a small a point. Okay, okay, so see here, number of shared electrons between, on the basis of what beta? Number of shared electrons between, okay, between the constituent atom, between the constituent atoms, and whatever your small b is what? Charges produce. So this basically in types of covalent bond we are considering. Okay, so see here how we can elaborate this small a and small b. Okay, so whenever we are comparing with number of, yes, on the basis of number of shared electrons between the two constituents atoms. Okay, so see here again that it will further classified into what? Single covalent bond. What, beta? Single covalent bond. So how in single covalent bond how we can identify this? So see here, single covalent bond means, suppose if you are considering here hydrogen molecule. What, beta? Here hydrogen molecule. So beta, here you must know what is hydrogen molecule, what is the chemical formula of that. So hydrogen molecule is what, beta? Simply H2. So single covalent bond example, so as you know, hydrogen atomic number 1, electronic configuration also 1. So here 1 electrons, valence electron also 1, and here hydrogen, for this hydrogen also 1. Okay, so I already told whatever your hydrogen they are completing is duplet. So duplet C as like this, yes, 2 electron duplet completed means here hydrogen is your stable, and here 2 electron also completed means your simply is what? Hydrogen molecule, like this. Okay, hydrogen molecule. Understood? So whatever these are, your bond will form, this bond will form. So we call it as a what? Bond pairs or shared pair of electrons. And in your hydrogen, there is a no what? A lone pairs. Okay, there is no extra electrons. So here single covalent bond means we saw here example of what? Single covalent bond. Now we will discuss here small b, or second Roman notation, double covalent bond, how we can form. Okay, double covalent bond. So double covalent bond like this, for we have to take example here oxygen molecule. What, beta? Here oxygen molecule. So see here oxygen molecule like this, O2. So you must know here this oxygen, this another oxygen. Okay, so we have to, you must know their atomic number and electronic configuration. Okay, so each oxygen how much? Yes, 8. So with atomic number 8, so electronic configuration 2,6. Here also what? 2,6. But whenever we are trying to draw the structure, we want what? Valence electrons 6. So beta, see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, either you write here or either you write here, because we are to form bond here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Understood? So see here how it will form a bond, double covalent bond, how it here form. Okay, so see, if you are considering this oxygen, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here see, octet is completed. Yes, understood. And for this taking example oxygen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Understood. So this 8 electron. Now here mutual sharing here. So what we call this? Electrons, shared pair of electrons, and whatever bond pairs. Okay, so we get like this, double bond with these what? Valence electrons. We call it as what? That lone pairs of electrons. Keep in mind this. Okay, I hope you understood this all, how we can form a double bond. Okay, so now we will move towards the next third Roman notation, triple covalent bond. Okay, so see here triple covalent bond. So triple covalent bond, yes, example is what? N2, your nitrogen molecule. As you know, mostly which gases are present in air? N2 and O2. O2 we discussed. Now it's time to discuss what? N2. So like that, nitrogen, this nitrogen, okay. So atomic number 7, electron configuration what? 2,5. Here also what? 2,5. So for drawing the structure, we need of these valence electrons. Okay. So ready with this. So as like this, see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Understood? 5. We gave 5 for you. Well, valence electrons of that each nitrogen atom we gave. Okay. So now here, what will happen? Yes. See, this mutual sharing here will occur here also. So how much bond? Yes, 3 bond will form. Okay. Understood. So see how they are completing its octet, Lewis octet, according to Lewis octet rule. Okay. So see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So for this nitrogen, you have to do like this. 8 electron octet is complete. Now here what will happen like this? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 electron completed. Okay, so formation of what? N2 molecule. Understood? And we got like this N, triple bond N, like this. If you are writing on this head, no issues. Okay, so these are what? But lone pairs. And whatever these are what? Bond pairs or shared pair of electrons. Understood? So here we form N2 molecule also. Okay, so this what belongs to first on the basis of what? Shared electrons between the constituent atoms. Okay, now we will discuss here whatever in small b on the basis of charges produced. Okay, yes, beta, on the basis of charges produced. Ready with this. Now see, on the basis of charges produced, how we can draw this. Okay, so here what beta? Mainly attraction force here existed, mainly this type of what? In this type, the attraction force existed by each atom. Attraction, yes, attraction force existed. Okay, attraction force existed, or we can say what better? Exerted. Attraction force exerted by each atom, and it may be similar or different. It may be similar or different. So here this thing you have to keep in mind, whatever that attraction force exerted is similar or different. Okay, so we'll see here. It belongs to another subtypes. We call it the what? Beta, subtype. So non-polar covalent compound. Non-polar covalent compound, or we can say what? Non-polar covalent bond. So see here, non-polar covalent bond means what? Okay, so non-polar, I already discussed polarity, polar and non-polar. Okay, so non-polar means what? Say here, suppose if you are considering this Cl molecule, Cl2 molecule. So we discussed this Cl2 molecule. Okay, so beta, in this Cl2 molecule means both having the same electronegativity. Yes, so whatever this chlorine, they are exerted, their dipole moment is what? Yes, their dipole moment is like this. Means each chlorine having a similar tendency to attract that electron toward itself. So beta, this dipole moment will cancel out each other, and you will get what? Non-polar molecule you will get. And same thing beta in H2 also, because both having same means attraction force exerted by each atom may be similar or different. In non-polar covalent bond is what? Yes, similar. So beta, whatever this H2 is what? Your non-polar covalent. Okay, so basically in this type no charges are produced. What beta here? In this type no charges are produced. Okay, understood. So non-polar means attracting same of both same electronegativity, so they will attract with the same force. So it will what? Their dipole moment is cancel out each other. Okay, and we call it as a what? That molecule we call it as a what? Non-polar. Understood. Now we will discuss. Yes, non-polar we discuss. Now it's time to discuss polar covalent bond. What beta? Polar covalent bond. Okay, so beta, here in polar two poles were generated. Means what? Yes, here charges will develop. So how? See here. Okay, how charges will develop here? So HCl, hydrogen chloride, HCl hydrochloric acid. So if you are discussing this in detail, Cl, so among this HCl, which one is more electronegative? Yes, obviously your chlorine. So chlorine trying to attract electrons towards itself. So your hydrogen becomes what? Plus, plus to minus. So here polarity will generate. Means what we call this? Polar covalent bond. Polar covalent bond. Here beta dipole moment, it may not cancel out. Okay, because more electronegative element is Cl. They are attracting electrons toward itself. Now here, suppose if you are considering HF, same thing will happen, more electronegative, your fluorine, so like this, from plus to negative, so this sign of dipole moment, so what you will get here, polarity will develop, two pole, negative pole, positive pole will generate, so polar covalent, okay, polar covalent bond here prepared. Understood. So it is very much easy if you understood this. Okay, now we will discuss some here properties of covalent compounds. Okay, so see here beta, properties of, yes, say properties of covalent compound. In properties of covalent compounds, so generally reverse of properties of ionic compounds. So beta, physical state, we will discuss first what here, physical state. So generally whatever these covalent compounds, generally gases or liquids at room temperature, but whatever higher molecular mass compounds, covalent compound, either what? Solids at room temperature. Okay, this thing you must know. Okay, now second, if you are discussing this hardness, okay, so it quite less hard as compared to ionic compounds. Okay, covalent compounds are not hard due to what beta? Weak attractive forces present in them. Okay, if you are discussing here third, so third is what beta? Conductivity. So in conductivity, generally what? Covalent compounds are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Covalent compounds are what? Poor conductor of heat and electricity. And suppose if you are discussing here, whatever basically your covalent compounds have what? Yes, low melting and boiling point. Low melting and boiling, yes, boiling point. Okay, so because of weak attractive forces, attraction present in them, weak intermolecular forces of attraction. Next we will discuss solubility. What beta here? Solubility. So solubility, covalent compounds are generally soluble in non-polar solvents. covalent compounds are generally soluble in non-polar solvents. Means, are you remembering non-polar solvents? So I already discussed one thing here. What I discussed? Like dissolves like, I discuss here. So like dissolves like means what? Yes, I means polar molecules are dissolved in polar solvent and non-polar molecules are dissolving non-polar solvent. Okay, so we will take here one example. So ready with this example. So see here, Br2, as you know, yes, Br2. So this Br2, whatever in gaseous form, so this Br2, okay, so your bromine is what, beta, liquid. So whatever that liquid, they are forming gas. So this Br2 dissolve in, okay, dissolve in CCl4. So this CCl4 is what, carbon tetrachloride. So beta, this carbon tetrachloride is non-polar. So how these are non-polar? So concentrate on this. Okay, I am taking here, I am explaining here. So Br and this Br, yes, they are attracting what, same here. Okay, so their double moment will cancel out each other, means the which type of bond it is, or which type of this molecule, non-polar. Okay, this non-polar, and if you are considering this CCl4, okay, so see, if you are considering this CCl4, so how your CCl4, your carbon, okay, chlorine and here chlorine. So this carbon octet will complete 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, and what, lone pairs also present on this chlorine, like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So most fully is prepared, fully what, molecule is ready. So beta, as you know, yes, chlorine, among the carbon and chlorine, which one is more electronegative? Yes, chlorine. So they are attracting whatever electron towards itself, and here also same. Okay, so here also same. So here beta, their dipole moment cancel out each other, and you will get what, a non-polar solvent. Means whatever my statement, non-polar molecule dissolving non-polar solvent. Okay, these are what, example, Br2 in CCl4. Okay, this what, Br2 in CCl4, it is a solvent, laboratory solvent also. Okay, so keep in mind this. Understood? I hope you understood this all. Okay, regarding what, beta, properties of covalent compound also. Understood? If you have any doubts, you can send. Okay, so one thing also here, that is coordinate covalent bond. Okay, one important bond, coordinate covalent bond. So see how it can form coordinate covalent bond. One, here we want one electron rich compound, and another what, electron deficient we want. Means one having electron rich, electron deficient. Okay, so see here, as like this example, what, NH3. So see here, NH3. Okay, so here octet and now everything is completed, nitrogen also octet complete, hydrogen duplet also completed. So basically what we call this as a electron rich, your what here, ammonia plus H plus. So with H plus means what here, whatever atomic number here, what, one. So one minus plus means what, minus. So again it will totally, it is electron deficient. So abhi wo electron ka bhuka hai, electron ka bhuka hai. Understood? Jo kuch ek electron tha iske paas, wo bhi chala gaya. Means plus one, whatever electron ka atomic number here, one. So if you're writing here plus, means what, one minus again one, so zero. So obviously very much electron deficient. Okay, now here what will happen, coordinate means, co means what, sharing here. Okay, electron rich, electron deficient. So see, you will get like this, hydrogen, nitrogen, hydrogen. Okay, so whatever your nitrogen, they are sharing electrons with hydrogen. Okay, so we call this bond as a what? Dative bond. What beta? Dative bond, or see this type of bond we call it as a what? Coordinate covalent bond. Or what beta here? Yes, coordinate covalent bond. Okay. Means nitrogen sharing electrons with hydrogen. Now hydrogen also duplet also complete. Okay. Then it acquires what? Positive charge. And further we call this what here? Whatever this prepared. We call it is what? NH4 plus. And this NH4 plus is what? Ammonium ion. Okay. So same example we can write, or you have to write in your notebook. But the example of what? H2O plus H plus, you have to write and tell me the what? Tell me the molecule after doing like this. What will form? That you have to tell me. Okay. So these are what we discuss, all these covalent compound with their types. I hope you understood all. If suppose still if you have any doubt, you can send on WhatsApp. Okay, we are always ready to guide you. Okay, so stay safe, stay home, and take care. Okay, so thank you, Vida.